Вы studied Илья Комонартович, divided into the Iliac External and Iliac Internal. If you remember, Iliac External artery gave only two branches. Who remembers? What are them? Iliac External artery. What branches gave?
Superficial femoral artery.
Deep circumflex.
Circumflex iliac deep artery. Arteria circunflexa iliaca profunda. And arteria epigastrica inferior, which goes to the humbus. Do you see why I recollected these branches for you? Because when the iliac external artery goes below and it is located at first behind of the inguinal ligament, and when it comes below than the inguinal ligament, it changes its name. It will be arteria femoralis. Arteria femoralis. It gives the branches. I recollected you the branches of the iliac external artery, especially for the understanding of another artery. It gives, do you see, the branch which is placed behind of the skin on the anterior abdominal wall and is called epigastric superficial. Another artery, it goes along over the external side of the iliac, is called circumflex iliac superficial. They are so analogy of the branches from iliac external, but they are placed, do you see, external, superficially. Another artery, which start from femoral artery, they are placed very often by two, and they go to the external sex organs. They are called pudendal external arteries. Very often they are two. And another artery is very, very big. It is called deep femoral artery. But look, please, here, I don't know, do you see what students did? Do you see, this is femoral artery, do you see? And this is its continuation. Because here students, do you see, yet some portion of the artery, I don't know how. Now I will try.
Defemoral.
Look, please, here. You can see. This is.
Common man, all of
इधर ना
ये रिया
वो दोनों पार्ट एंड में कुछ आएंगे
पेंसिल लेके
पेंसिल टेस्ट से भी मोटी है
रिफिल निकाल के
मैं पीछे साइड डाले ना
हाँ रिफिल
काढ़ूं दे ना
ओ भाई ताकत
मैं रुको तो रिफिल भी निकाल दे
ना मैं निकाल दूँ
अदर
Ma'am, take this.
Подожди.
Oh, yeah.
No, give me.
Okay.
हम पे तो भरोसा ही
नहीं है
क्या पता इसको स्पेशल नाम दे चुप रहे उसको अलग नाम बताएगी
मैं YouTube
का चैनल
चेंज कर दो do you see This is femoral artery. Do you see? This is femoral. This is femoral. My dear, because I said you students do you see cut it out the some portion. No, because do you see from a long story the tissues are not very strong. Do you see? And students do you see cut it this portion of the femoral artery. From femoral artery begins very biggest branch which is called deep femoral artery. This is the arteria profunda femoris. This is arteria profunda femoris. It gives As a circumflex femoral lateral, are the circumflex femoris lateralis, which will go to the anterior group of the muscles of the thigh, and it gives branch to the thigh joint. You can see it gives circumflex femoris medialis, which will go to the medial side, and which will help for the blood supply of the medial group of the thigh, which was supplied yet by obturator artery. Do you remember? And do you see another continuation of the, do you see, deep femoral artery? It goes to the back and divides into three branches. When the three branches come to the back, and they are called perforant arteries, do you see, they will be superior, medial, and inferior. No, at first they will supply, do you see, the different floors of the posterior muscles of the thigh. And do you see, superior perforant artery, it gives diaphysis ascending. Inferior, do you see, perforant artery, it gives diaphysis descending. This is a deep femoral artery. What do you do? You can see deep femoral artery gave circumflex femoris lateralis, circumflex femoris medialis, and three perforant arteries, superior, medial, and inferior. After giving, do you see, of these arteries, do you see femoral artery passes by femoral triangle to its tip. Do you see, this is tip of the femoral triangle. Do you see, this is femoral triangle. Laterally will be sartorius, medially will be adductor longus, above will be inguinal ligament. And you can see this artery comes by tip of the femoral triangle into the adductor canal. Do you see? When the artery passes through the femoral triangle, it is placed near the muscles, because by our order about short distance, it supplies the muscles which are located near it. When it comes into the adductor canal, last time we studied adductor canal, do you remember? Saphenous nerve, do you see, from femoral nerve enters together with femoral artery into the adductor canal. I will recollect you. Adductor canal has three openings. The upper, do you see, like enter, this will be the tip of the femoral triangle. The, do you see, extra exit will be near the upper border of the medial condyle of the femur. Do you remember here, exact continuation of the nervous saphenous, which is called cutaneous crura medialis. And here, do you see, from femoral artery will exit branch to the capsule of knee joint. Mm-hmm. And it is called genus descending artery, artery genus descending. And another continuation of the femoral artery from adductor canal will go to the back into the popliteal fossa and will change name, will be popliteal artery. Popliteal artery, it gives to the muscles which are placed near muscular branches, and it gives, do you see, to the capsule of knee joint, genus superior medial, genus superior lateral, genus inferior medial, genus inferior lateral. And also, it gives branch which perforates posterior side of the capsule, enters into the articular cavity, and is called genus medial artery. Okay. If you remember, knee joint, it is complex. Inside, besides bony articulary surfaces, between them it has cartilage pillows, which are called meniscuses. And these meniscuses also, they are kept by ligaments, do you see, which are placed inside in the capsule, intercapsular or intraarticular ligaments. And these ligaments, do you see, must be supplied like meniscuses, because popliteal artery gives, specially for the blood supply of the meniscuses and ligaments, genus medial artery. You can see from popliteal artery, we have beginning of the five arteries. genus superior, this medial lateral, genus inferior medial lateral, and genus medial, which enters into the articulary cavity. Below, in the rhomboid shape of the cubit of the popliteal fossa, you can see popliteal artery divides into the tibialis posterior, which goes into the crura-popliteal canal. Into the crura-popliteal canal, you can see here is tibialis posterior and tibialis anterior. Tibialis anterior perforates interossal membrane and comes in front of. Here, do you see, it will go below, in front of, do you see, here it will go below, and it will locate, do you see, behind of the anterior muscles. Anterior muscles will be tibialis anterior, extensor digitorum longus, extensor hallucis longus. It is placed deeply behind of these muscles, and because it supplies them. But this is what? Tibialis anterior. Tibialis anterior, before its, do you see, visit in front of, give the opposite branch, recurrence tibialis posterior. When it comes in front of, before its continuation below, it gives opposite branch, recurrence tibialis anterior. Last time we started with the low vein. And do you remember, for the control of foot, do you see, I recollected you the control of the skin of the hand, skin and muscles. Do you remember? Mm-hmm. And I said to you, if we will stand by four limbs, mm-hmm. the lower limb will be so-so energy of the upper limb. About what I want to inform you, do you remember elbow joint? Who remembers how it is supplied? At first collateral, because all of which come from upper, they are collateral. Recurrence, they will come for a meeting with them. I will recollect you, collateral radial from deep brachial, which is anastomosis with recurrence radial from radial. Collateral medial from deep brachial profunda brachia will anastomosis with recurrence interossal from interossal posterior. Collateral ulnar superior anastomosis with recurrence ulnar posterior. Collateral ulnar inferior again from brachial anastomosis with recurrence ulnar anterior. How many arteries supply the elbow joint?
Eight.
Look, let's get two here, and four for the emission. Eight arteries. You can see what will be knee joint. Knee joint will be so energy of the elbow joint. And you can see descending genus from the femoral artery. Five popliteal arteries, do you remember? Mm-hmm. And do you see two recurrence arteries from tibialis anterior? How many arteries?
Eight.
But for the elbow joint, the all arteries, they do arterial plexus, arterial articulary plexus, yes? For the knee joint, one artery enters inside from this eight. Do you see one artery enters inside for the blood supply of the internal biology things. Do you understand? But genus descending, genus popliteal superior, lateral medial, genus inferior, medial and lateral, recurrence tibialis anterior and recurrence tibialis posterior, seven, they do plexus. And the genus medial, it enters inside into the articulary cavity. You can see tibialis anterior, it goes behind of the anterior muscles, supplies them. When it crosses in front of the ankle joint, it gives arteria malleolaris anterior, medial, arteria malleolus anterior lateral. And after that, it exits.
No, here it is cut. Here it exits, do you see here?
And directs, do you see, by dorsal side of the foot. When it comes to the back of the foot, it is called arteria dorsalis pedis, dorsal pedis artery. And before its continuation to the first metatarsal space, it gives tarsal lateral and tarsal medial artery. They supply the intertarsal joints and they supply the muscles of the short group of the foot. Do you see? Extensor digitorum brevis and extensor hallucis brevis, and also interossal dorsal muscles for the abduction. When this artery comes to the level which accords, do you see, the metatarsal bones, do you see, it will rotate, it will give branch to lateral side. It is called arteria arcuata, arcuate artery. Arcuate artery, no, by 50-50, by 50% anastomosis with tarsal. By 50%, tarsal has blind end and arcuate has blind end. But from arcuate artery, like on the upper limb, begin metatarsal dorsal arteries into the second interdigital fold, do you see, third, fourth, and to the lateral side of the back of the fifth finger. Arcuate artery gives four metatarsal dorsal arteries. Three from them will come into the interdigital folds. We will start from second, do you see? And the, do you see, fourth will go along of the dorsal lateral side of the fifth finger to its tip. Do you understand? From these arteries, metatarsal dorsal, in the each intercostal space will begin to arteries. Digital dorsal, which will go to the sides of the back of the fingers, which look, do you see, at this interdigital fold. Do you understand? Another branch. Who там? Who is it? Who там? Russian or foreign?
No.
Nobody. You can see. Another branch of the dorsalis pedis artery, it is called metatarsal dorsal first, arteria metatarsal dorsalis prima. But it will go to both sides, it will subdivide to both sides of the two, and it will give branch to the medial dorsal side of the second finger. Mm-hmm. Do you remember, like digital common, but they are called metatarsal dorsal, which divide into the digital dorsal, and also we will get the metatarsal dorsal first, arteria metatarsal dorsalis prima. And after that, you can see, dorsalis pedis gave tarsal lateral, tarsal medial, arcuate, metatarsal dorsal first. And after that, look what's here, by first metatarsal space, it directs to the plantar side. Look, please, here. It comes to the plantar side. And when, do you see, it passes through the first metatarsal space, by this distance, it is called plantaris profunda, deep plantar artery, plantaris profunda. Remember, please, I showed it you. Do you see? You can see arteria tibialis posterior. Arteria tibialis posterior, it goes by crura popliteal canal between soleus behind and tibialis posterior in front, and it gives muscular branches to the posterior group. Posterior group includes gastrocnemius, soleus, tibialis posterior, flexor digitorum longus, flexor hallucis longus. It supplies them. In the lower third of the crura popliteal canal, or in the lower third of the back of the leg, it gives to the lateral side arteria peronea. Arteria peronea will come to the lateral side specially for the blood supply of the lateral group, peroneus longus, peroneus brevis. And it gives articulation branch to the ankle joint. Do you see? You can see arteria piranea supplies the lateral group, which includes piraneus longus, piraneus brevis, and gives articulation branch, which do the sprills into the branches, which will do net together with branches of the tibialis anterior, malleolaris, malleolaris anterior medialis, malleolaris anterior lateralis. After that, do you see arteria tibialis posterior, do you see, goes below and behind of the medial malleolus, it again, like do you see anterior artery, gives branches. Arteria malleolaris posterior medial, arteria malleolaris posterior lateral. And because ankle joint is supplied by 5 arteries. Two malleolar artery from tibialis anterior, two malleolar artery from tibialis posterior, and arteria piranea. After that, arteria tibialis posterior comes to the plantar side and divides into the plantaris medialis and into the plantaris lateralis. Plantaris medialis, look this here, it will go by plantar medial groove, do you see, to the beginning of the base of the metatarsal bones. Plantaris lateralis will go between flexor digitorum brevis and quadratus plantaris into the plantar lateral groove. Will come, do you see, to the heads of the metatarsal bones and will rotate from laterally to medially and will come into the plantar medial groove for the contact with plantaris medialis. Plantaris medialis and plantaris lateralis, by their communication, they do plantar arc. Plantar arc. Listen to me. From plantar arc will begin metatarsal plantar. Metatarsal plantar. Metatarsal plantar will go into the all interdigital folds. And do you see, and here do you see, in the interdigital folds, they will divide, do you see, into the plantar digital arteries. Do you see plantar dorsal digital and plantar digital on both sides, like on the upper limb, well, anastomosis bicollateral digital. Do you remember? But you can see here, do you see, only first, do you see, artery will give 3 branches to both sides, do you see, of the, two sides of the fingers, which look at first metatarsal space, do you see, and do you see, to the medial side of the plantar region of the toe, do you see? You can see plantar, metatarsal plantar will divide into the digital plantar for the blood supply of the fingers. But what I want to inform you, arcus plantaris, it is formed by short plantaris medialis and long plantaris lateralis. Do you remember? Deep plantar artery communicates with what? No, with what? It communicates. Deep plantar artery anastomosis communicates with what? With lateral plantar artery. About what I want to inform you. Do you remember on the palmar side, we have superficial palmar arc and deep. And I informed you about what? If we will press by lesser back, weight of the lesser back, we will, do you see, press the superficial arc or digital common arteries. If we will take the bigger weight of the back, for example, 10 kilograms, we will press, do you see, the superficial arc and digital common, we will press the deep arc beta carpal palmar, and the blood will come from retrocarpi dorsalis by meta carpal dorsal. Do you remember? Listen to me, I forgot to inform, metacarpal dorsal, do you see, they will divide into the digital dorsal. The, do you see, metacarpal palmar and digital common, they will give branch into the digital propria. But I forgot to inform, do you remember here we have all the muscles? And if we press here arteries from metatarsal dorsal, between metatarsal spaces, perforant arteries will open into the meta carpal palmar. Did I say? Okay, listen to me. What will be here? Every time we press the plantar side.
Yes.
But our God gave us many protections. At first, this do remember, arches of the plantar side. If you remember, we have there, do you see, five longitudinal arches and one, do you see, horizontal arc. Very, very high arc, this is second longitudinal arc to the base of the second metatarsal bone from calcaneus tuber, do you see? But you can see, here we have arches, do you see, and you see, this will be protection for the comfort position of the artist without pressing. Did you see?
Yes.
Okay. This is one moment, but no, some people have, do you see, flat arches, flat plantar side, but no, for example, we will take normal persons with arches. Sometimes you go to swim in the sea, yes?
Mm-hmm.
And do you see, and anywhere do you see will be, you know, so soft, do you see, border of the sea, yes? And sometimes will be stones. And when you stand on stone,
mm-hmm.
you can press arches.
Mm-hmm.
You can see, especially for this, for example, the some persons do physical exercises, do you remember, on the, do you see, stick, do you remember, and they stand like here, do you see, and they can press the fiber arches, because on the foot, the arches are placed perpendicularly, will be plantar medial, plantar lateral, and will be dorsal pedis deep plantar into the plantar lateral. Do you see?
Mm-hmm.
Because every time by our walking, jumping, running, or standing, do you see, on the any stone, the blood will come below. Do you see? You can see this is blood supply of the lower body. But if you remember, on the lectures, I informed you, we have arteries which bring the blood with the oxygen and things for nutrition of the old tissues. In the tissues will be metabolism, and after this, this metabolism, the veins take out the deoxygenated blood with things from metabolism. And veins every time are placed along of the arteries. They have the same names and they drainate the same objects which arteries supply. And these are everywhere. But besides this, we have the some extra veins. Do you remember I said you the number of the veins is more than the number of the arteries? I said you, for example, aorta exits, do you see, and two veins return blood into the heart. Besides these two general veins, we have also special helping portal vein. If you remember, I said you the lesser veins, they are placed by two alone of the one artery. But, and also, we have the some special veins which drainate the skin. And these veins are placed, do you see, on the limbs. For example, we have brachial artery, which divides into the radial and ulnar.
Mm-hmm.
And by the continuation below, they give very, do you see, short thinner branches to the different levels of the skin. We don't give the special names of these branches because they can begin by different levels, do you see, and the number of them is very biggest. But we have the special veins which drainate the skin of the upper and lower limb. Look at my hand.
Mm-hmm.
Do you see
mm-hmm.
blue
yes.
branches?
Yes.
Here will be plexus venosus dorsalis manus hand.
Yes.
Plexus venosus dorsalis manus. This whole plexus net completes into the vein. And this vein, along of the lateral side of the forearm, and completes here the smaller veins, along of the lateral side of the arm, do you see, completes here the smaller vein. It comes, do you see, into the, do you see, shoulder region, and here between deltoid muscle and pectoral major by this groove. It goes inside and opens into the vena arteries, which is placed along of the same artery. This vein, if we will look how it continues, do you see? The scientist, when he tried to examine here, he had association. It wants go to the head. The head is called cephalon, and vein is called cephalic. On the palmar side is placed plexus venosus palmaris manus, do you see? Mm-hmm. And from this plexus completes the vein, which goes along of the medial side of the forearm, comes above the cubital fossa and opens into the brachial vein, above the cubital fossa. This is called basilic vein, basilic, basal, do basil, you see? Right. When we sit very often leg base, do you see basilic vein? Listen to me. Here will be cephalic, here will be basilic. In front of the cubital fossa will be big bridge between cephalic and basilic. Sometimes the diameter of the cephalic and basilic can be lesser than the bridge between them. This is cubital vein. This vein is your professional branch. Very often you will do injections into these veins. Because this is so easy vein for the, do you see, comfort contact with patient, do you see? Yeah. And you can see this will be vena cubitae, cubital vein. And do you see the blue color?
Yes.
Do you see? Here can be or cannot be, or can be by different number. Here can be antebrachial anterior vein. It opens into the cubital vein if it is placed. It can be long, do you see? It can be placed by two, it can be placed by three, and it can be absent. But basilic and cephalic, they are constantly, and bridge between them is constantly. You can see on the dorsal side of the foot, do you see, is located plexus venosus dorsalis pedis, from which will be formed vein, which will go above along of the medial side of the leg, along of the medial side of the leg, along of the medial side of the thigh. And do you see, it opens, this is it, it opens into the femoral vein. Do you remember, this is vein, this is artery, and this is nerve. From medially, do you see, to laterally will be vein, artery, and nerve. In Russian fairy tales, very often the hero has name Vanya. This will be vein, artery, nerve. Do you see? This, do you see, is long saphenous vein. Long saphenous vein begins here, goes above along of the medial side, and by its visit above, everywhere collects the blood from skin by smaller branches, except plantar side and except back of the leg. Because here will be plexus venosus plantaris pedis, from which will begin vein, which will go through the center of the back of the leg and will open into the popliteal vein. It is called vena saphena parva. This is called vena saphena magna, but in the English book it is long saphenous vein. Magna, this is big, but it is translated long by English long. This will be vena saphena parva. Parva is, do you see, lesser, and it will be translated like short.
Short.
Vena saphena parva, it opens into the popliteal, the vena saphena magna into the femoral. Did you understand?
Yes.
This is a break by 20.